everyone, and welcome to the Church of the Ascension. I would also like to take a moment to welcome friends and family who are joining us via live stream. Would you now please rise?
I can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to sing at all? What I can only imagine. I can only imagine.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. On behalf of this parish, I would like to welcome our distinguished guests who have come to join with us for this Mass of the Resurrection of our brother John. He was a member of this wonderful community, and he was also part of our life here at the Church of Ascension. What he has left to us is a legacy to keep our faith steady. And I would like to extend our condolences to the family, especially for John and your sister, for the loss of your dad. But something that is very powerful to acknowledge, that wherever we go in our life, we have to acknowledge that God is always with us. John, when they called me to go and see him and give him the sacrament of anointing, he was waiting me, sitting on a couch, and I prayed with him, and he was in a very good spirit, and he said, I love Jesus. And he put his trust even at the moment when he was struggling with all the pains, but with love and peace. Let us continue to pray for his journey of life, and we are sure John is in the hands of God. Amen.
In the waters of baptism, John died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him in eternal glory. The altar, the vestments worn by the clergy are white, remind us of the day of John's baptism. He had a white garment put on him to signify his new life in Christ. Today, we believe he is clothed in glory. On that day, John's baptismal candle was lit from the Easter candle, challenging him to be a light for the world. And we believe that he is indeed a Christian light for others that now shines brightly for all eternity.
Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant John, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask thee through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything. And a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to give birth, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embrace. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into their hearts so they cannot find out. From beginning to end, the work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Would you please rise?
Have to die. Close to my word, keep faithful. For your faithfulness, I will give you the crown of life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may also be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Last February, I stood right where I am now, and I talked about Kathleen Shearon. So some of the points you're about to hear may sound familiar, but they are important points, things we need to keep in mind about the promises of Jesus Christ and eternal life. We are united today in sorrow at the death of John. To the Shearon family, we offer comfort and condolences in your time of grief. The reality of death, with all its pain and sense of loss, confronts us at this moment. But as we are united in sorrow, we are also united in something else, our faith. Confronted by the reality of death, we must allow ourselves to be confronted by the reality of our faith. Faith is not a maybe or an I hope so or wishful thinking. It is a reality. Our faith opens our minds to the whole picture about life, death, and what happens after death. Only in the light of faith can we begin to understand what has happened to John and how we are to keep going from here. When in our faith we speak about heaven and resurrection and the next life, we do not speak about these things primarily because they give us consolation and strength. They certainly do that. But the primary reason that we speak of these things is because they are true. God has spoken his word to us. We hear it in the scriptures and in the teachings of the church. And we respond by saying, "Yes, I believe it is true." God has spoken the silence, has broken the silence about death, and has told us that he has conquered it. Death was not part of God's original plan. It came into the world because of sin. Yet God did not leave us in death's power. He sent Christ, Christ who died and rose again and conquered death. God has spoken to the world through Christ. He told us that he wants to give us victory over death in and through Jesus Christ. Because of this, Christians are not silent in the face of death. Many people, on coming to a wake or to a funeral, do not know what to say. Death seems to have had the last word. But we who believe are not silent. We speak. Christ has risen. Death has been conquered. Many think that the story of human life is birth, life, and death. For Christians, it's different. The story is not birth, life, and death, but rather life, death, and resurrection. Death does not have the last word. Life does. Death is not the last sentence in the last chapter of the human story. It's the middle. There is another chapter to come. The end of the story is resurrection and a life that has no end. The farewell that we give John today is a temporary farewell. The burial that we give John is a temporary burial. He will live. He will rise. The ceremony today contains reminders of John's baptism. In his baptism, the life of the risen Christ was poured into John's soul. He began to share, here on earth, the life of heaven. God rescued John from the power of death on that day. He literally snatched him from the dominion of death and transferred him to the kingdom of Christ, a kingdom of eternal life. Christ said to John on that day, "You do not belong to death, you belong to me." A Christian does not merely die. A Christian dies in Christ. Those two words, in Christ, make all the difference in the world. We belong by baptism to him, and we live in him in a life of prayer, obedience to the church teachings, and faithfulness to the sacraments of the church. If we live in Christ and die in Christ, we will rise in Christ. John was a husband, a father, and a grandfather. He was a hard worker and blessed with an inquisitive mind. He employed a hands-on approach to life and was always looking to improve things. He had an outgoing personality and always enjoyed a good joke. That combination served him well in his career in the HVAC business, heating and ventilation and air conditioning, that's what it is. Business. Anyway, it served him well in his HVAC business and earned him the Mr. Fix-It nickname. His family was important to him. Along with his wife of 46 years, Kathleen, he was part of the old school parents team in the Shearon household. The Catholic faith was important to him, and in their marriage, he enjoyed a deep, loving relationship with Kathleen. His behavior was modeled to his children. Follow the rules. Own your actions. No cutting corners were lessons that John taught to John and Bridget. Support for his children and grandchildren was always present. Staying connected with his adult children was a priority for John. Joy in his children was abundantly present, especially for Bridget when John held a grandchild for the first time, or for his son John when, as the coach of a youth lacrosse team, he earned his first victory. His was a life well lived, and I'm sure he will be missed. In the midst of all this, should we grieve? Yes, it is okay to grieve, and it is natural because we love John. Yes, we grieve as Christians, but we grieve with hope. It is okay to be sad today that we do not see John anymore, but it would be wrong to think that we will never see him again. It is okay to grieve, but it is wrong to despair. Christ is alive. We pray today for John that he may complete his journey to heaven. Pray for him every day. And for yourselves, look at him and say with faith, John, you do not belong to death. You belong to Christ. And so do we. Amen.
Please stand. God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, and especially as we are preparing to continue to pray for John and also for the needs of our lives.
Lord, scatter the darkness we experience now and lead John across the waters of death into life, for you have given him the pledge of eternal life in his baptism. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you fed John at your table with the Eucharist. He shared in the bread of life that promises eternal life. May he now find his place at your banquet table in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, John served his country for 4 years in the Navy. May his efforts and those that follow bring about lasting peace in all the lands. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, help John's 3 grandchildren remember him through wonderful stories that he indeed had a great love for them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, for all who we have helped us, that they may have the rewards of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our tears of sorrow for John be turned into tears of joy. Awareness of the life that he now experiences in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters, cleanse them of their sins, and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask thee through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Would you please rise?
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant John, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for you, a faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and the dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Barry, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant John, whom you have called from this world to yourself, Grant that he who was united with you, a son, in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and gracious grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, would even reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us share with each other a sign of peace.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Please be seated. For those of our guests who do not share in our Catholic Eucharistic faith tradition, we'd like to invite you forward with your hands folded over your heart, and you'll receive a blessing from one of the clergy.
One bread, one body, one Lord of all. One cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body in this one Lord. Gentile or Jew, servant or free, woman or man, one body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body one Lord. Many the gifts, many the works, one in the Lord of all. One breath, one body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body one Lord.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother John may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Good afternoon. My name is Stacy Donahue. I'm John's niece. His sister, Pat Donahue, is my mother. John Patrick and Bridget asked me to read their thoughts on their dad today. We are in disbelief that in just under 10 months, we are now without both our mom and our dad. Our hearts are broken, but we do believe that dad just couldn't wait to be back with mom and to be happy again. Anyone who knew our parents in life knew how much they loved each other, and so we're comforted that they are now reunited. Dad was a one-of-a-kind man. He was a great husband, father, papa, and friend. Our dad was the rock in our family. He was tough in raising us, but he did it all with love and in our best interest. And he wasn't only tough love. He, like mom, was always cheering us on and supporting us in all that we did growing up. Dad never missed a sports event or a band function. In fact, he was usually volunteering at those events. And even among the volunteers, he was one of the first to arrive and the last to leave. Throughout our lives, he was always there to support whatever crazy ideas we had. And he often had a few crazy ideas of his own. He shot off homemade potato guns on Thanksgiving. He did keg stands at Bridget and Sean's going away party when they moved to Italy in 2011. Anyone who knew him knew that he was a ton of fun. One of the great things about our dad as a parent and as a person was his ability to listen to us and consider our thoughts fully, even though we were just growing up as children. One example that has become legendary in the Shearon family, Many years ago, the Shearons and the Donahues got together for some kind of holiday. Megan, our dad's niece, who was only 5 years old at the time, had become tearfully upset over something that her siblings or cousins had done. Our dad noticed, and he tried to comfort her. He said something to the effect of, "Don't worry about it, it's gonna be okay." And Megan glared up at him and very dramatically said, "You don't know my life." And our dad looked down at her, thought about it for a minute, and he said, "Well, you've got a point. I don't actually know your life." And that's how Dad was with everyone. He listened. He really heard what they were saying. And that's part of the reason that so many people loved him so much. In addition to being fully dedicated to his family, Dad worked over 40 years in HVAC, teaching his son and wingman, John Patrick, his trade along the way. When Dad retired, he took up running. He ran so that he could continue to drink his beloved scotch and Guinness and not worry about gaining weight. But he did more than just stay in shape. He became a very good runner. Just recently in August, Dad and Bridget ran a 5K race at ODU in Norfolk. He did fantastic, finishing at the top of his age group. But that's no surprise. He approached running like he did everything in life, with a lot of natural talent and steady dedication. The week after the 5K, we threw Dad a surprise party for his 80th birthday. Family and friends came in from all over the country to be there. With so many people involved, it seemed like he would somehow find out what we were up to. But by some miracle, he didn't. And when he walked into the house, looked around the corner into the living room, and saw 50 people standing there with balloons and banners, all of us saw something that we had rarely, if ever, seen before. Our dad, in stunned silence, visibly trying to keep his composure. He was so moved at the display of love for him. It was a truly beautiful scene to witness. But Dad was not speechless for long. Pretty soon after that, he had a beer in hand and spent the rest of the beautiful afternoon with a huge smile on his face, talking to everyone. He watched with amusement as his grandkids and nephew transformed one of the coolers and about 25 bottled waters into a kiddie swimming pool. He jumped into action to remove a huge snake that dropped out of a tree and landed on the shade covering above our guests' heads. And that's how we're going to remember our dad, full of life, and most importantly, full of love. We love you, Dad.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual life shine upon him.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother, John, in a sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon John in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and our relationship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his final resting place.
Please rise. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.